Sushruta for Neet is now available on the Google Play Store. Try it out for free.
Hello, my dear students. Hearty welcome to Jnanamarga Biology classes. I am Professor G.K. Bhatt. In the last class, we have studied the external morphology of cockroach, and also with reference to internal anatomy, we have completed the study of digestive system. Taking up further, let us now look into blood vascular system or circulatory system. The blood vascular system of cockroach is an open type. I hope you are familiar with open type of circulatory system and closed. In a closed type of circulatory system, the blood flows inside definite blood vessels, as you see in us, as you see in case of frog, as you see in case of earthworms. In all these, we come across closed circulatory system. So in cockroach, the blood flows inside the spaces in the body. The blood flows inside the body cavity. Hence, the body cavity in case of the cockroach, that is a blood-filled space in the body cavity, is referred to as hemocele. This should not be mistaken with what type of coelom you come across in cockroaches. If at all you are referring to the acoelomate condition, pseudomate condition, and coelomate condition, cockroach is a coelomate animal. And you also know, under this coelomate animals, cockroach comes under what is known as the schizocoelomate animal. Cockroach shows the body cavity, which is referred to as schizocoel. Body cavity is called schizocoel. So here, the body spaces or spaces inside the body which is filled with blood is known as hemocoel. Hemocoel refers to the body spaces filled with blood. This should not be mistaken with the schizocoel. What type of coelom you come across in cockroach? Answer is a schizocoel. The space inside the body of a cockroach is filled with blood, and it is referred to as a hemocoel. Hemocoel means blood-filled body space. This is what the space you come across in cockroach. Much of the space in the body is referred to as perivisceral sinus. What do you mean by perivisceral sinus? Perivisceral sinus is the space present around the viscera. The viscera of cockroach mainly consists of the alimentary canal. And surrounding this alimentary canal, you come across this space. This is referred to as a perivisceral sinus, and it is filled with the blood, and hence it is referred to as hemocoel. Let me just give you a little bit of more information with regard to this. If at all you see the cockroach, I am writing the diagrammatic sketch. Let us consider this the head, and this is the body proper of cockroach. In a body of cockroach, you come across space here in the center surrounding the alimentary canal. Surrounding the alimentary canal, and this space, whatever you come across here, this space is referred to as the perivisceral sinus. peri-visceral sinus, referring to the peri-visceral sinus, referring to the space present around the alimentary canal. Peri-visceral sinus. Sinus means a space. Peri-visceral sinus. And this space where you have the heart, here you come across the heart. Okay. This space, whatever you come across, where heart is present, this is referred to as pericardial sinus. Pericardial, referred to surrounding the heart. Pericardial sinus. And this space where you have the nervous system, nerve cord, this space is referred to as perineural sinus. Perineural sinus. Perineural sinus. And the space present inside head, this is referred to as head sinus. Okay. And in between these, in between the perivisceral sinus and pericardial sinus, there is a perforated diaphragm. This is called the dorsal diaphragm. Dorsal diaphragm. A plate or a partition which is perforated. Dorsal diaphragm. And this is called ventral diaphragm. Ventral diaphragm. Okay. This is ventral diaphragm with the perforation. So you must know, at the time of blood flow, from the heart, the blood flows in one direction, from posterior to anterior, and from the pericardial sinus, where is inside the pericardial sinus, you have the heart. This is heart. So the blood flows from the heart to the head sinus. From the head sinus, the blood flows to the perineural sinus. From the perineural sinus, the blood flows to perivisceral sinus. From the perivisceral sinus, through this perforation, the blood flows to pericardial sinus. And from the pericardial sinus, the blood flows through ostia into the heart. From the heart, the blood flows to the head sinus. From the head sinus, blood flows to the perineural sinus. From the perineural sinus, blood flows to perivisceral sinus. From the perivisceral sinus, blood flows to pericardial sinus. From the pericardial sinus, blood enters into heart. From the heart, again it goes to head sinus. So this is how the blood circulation takes place. Blood vessels are poorly developed and open into spaces called hemocele. Visceral organs located in the hemocele, here you come across visceral organs. Visceral organs located in hemocele are bathed in the blood. They are bathed. That means they are surrounded by the hemolymph. Blood of cockroach is called hemolymph. The hemolymph is composed of colorless plasma. Many times you might have stepped on the cockroach. If you step on the cockroach will die, and from its body, a white color fluid comes out. It is the blood of cockroach. Blood of cockroach is colorless. It is colorless, and this blood comes out, oozes out when you step on the cockroaches. The hemolymph is composed of colorless plasma, and it has cells in it, and these cells are called hemocytes. Hemocytes. Cyte refers to cells. Heme refers to blood. And these hemocytes are phagocytic in nature. That means they engulf whatever the foreign parties that enters into the body. Hand of cockroach consists of elongated muscular tube. Elongated muscular tube, you must know that this elongated muscular tube, that is the heart, it is made up of 13 chambers. That heart is of 13 chambers in cockroach. So heart is with the 13 chambers, and here you have enabling the heart to contract and relax. You have muscles, and these muscles are called alary muscles. Alary muscles, they are 12 pairs. There are 12 pairs of alary muscles enabling the heart to contract and relax. The heart in front continues as an anterior aorta, which opens into the head sinus. Heart of cockroach consists of elongated muscular tube lying along with the mid dorsal line of thorax and abdomen. You must know that heart in cockroach is dorsal. It is dorsal. In our body, heart is ventral in position. So there is a dorsal 13-chambered heart in case of cockroach. This is what the heart, and at the sides of the heart, you do come across apertures, and these apertures are called ostia. Through the ostia, the blood from the pericardial sinus enters into the heart, which cannot go back. The flow is a single direction, in one direction. So always you must remember, in this also, from the pericardial sinus, the blood can enter into the heart. What you see, all these dots, etc., they are the ostia. Through the ostia, blood can enter the heart, but cannot come out. From the heart, blood moves to in one direction, from posterior to anterior. Through the aorta, the blood comes to the head. From the head, the blood goes to the perineural sinus. From the perineural sinus, blood can flow in only one direction. From perineural sinus, sinus means a space, peri means surrounding, neural refers to nervous system. The space surrounding the nervous system is referred to as perineural space. From the perineural space, the blood can come to the perivisceral sinus, but it cannot go back. From the perivisceral sinus, blood can enter into pericardial sinus, but it cannot come back. So in this way, unidirectional flow is observed in the circulatory system of that of cockroach. Right? It is differentiated. Heart is differentiated into funnel-shaped chambers with ostia on either side. Through the ostia, blood can come into the heart but cannot go out through the ostium, unidirectional. Blood from sinuses enter heart through ostia and is pumped anteriorly to sinuses again. Okay, that's all about the circulatory system. Coming to the respiratory system. The respiratory system of a cockroach consists of a network of trachea that open through 10 pairs of small holes called spiracles present on the lateral side of the body. You must remember that the respiratory system of cockroach consists of tubes. What you see here, these are all the tubes, and these tubes, respiratory system, consists of 10 pairs of holes. What are they called? These holes are called spiracles. Look here. These are the holes, spiracles. Of the 10 pairs of spiracles, you come across 2 pairs situated in the thoracic region. They are called thoracic spiracles. Remaining 8 pairs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Remaining 8 pairs are situated in abdominal region. They are called abdominal spiracles. So, it is not mentioned in your NCERT book. You must know that in the thoracic region, there are two pairs of spiracles are in thoracic region, and they are called thoracic spiracles. Two pairs of spiracles are thoracic, and abdominal spiracles are 8 pairs. Altogether, you come across 10 pairs of spiracles, right? Thin branching tubes, what you see here, these are all branching tubes, what we call tracheal tubes. And these tracheal tubes are subdivided to form what is known as a tracheole. So, trachea divided to form tracheole. So these are tracheoles. You can see that these are the trachea. They are divided to form tracheoles. And these are tracheoles, they supply the oxygen to individual cells or tissues. So thin branching tubes called tracheal tubes, subdivided into tracheole, carry oxygen from the air to all the parts. Now, opening of the spiracles, we have already seen there are two pairs of spiracles in the thoracic region, 8 pairs of spiracles in the abdominal region. And all these spiracles are regulated by sphincter. As you know, sphincter refers to an aperture guarded with walls. By default, they always remain closed. Whenever they have function, at that time they open. So all these spiracles are regulated by sphincter. All the openings of the spiracles are regulated by the sphincters. The exchange of gases takes place at the tracheoles. At the tracheoles, the exchange of gases takes place by diffusion. So what you have to notice in case of cockroach? In case of cockroach, in the absence of hemoglobin pigment, that is why the blood color of cockroach is white. It is not red because there is no colored hemoglobin pigment. Our blood is red in color because our blood has hemoglobin pigment. Earthworm blood is red in color because earthworm blood has hemoglobin pigment, not in blood cells, but in blood plasma. So here, in the absence of hemoglobin pigment, in cockroach, the oxygen is directly supplied to the cells or tissues. Now let us look into excretion. Excretion is performed by Malpighian tubules. In the last class, you have heard the Malpighian tubules are present between the midgut and hindgut. You have noticed that there are 100 to 150 minute hair-like tubules, and these tubules are referred to as Malpighian tubules. Excretion is performed by Malpighian tubules. Each tubule is lined by glandular ciliated cells. They are the glandular cells and ciliated cells. They absorb nitrogen waste products. These tubules, they absorb nitrogen waste products from the space inside the body. You know, already heard that perivisceral sinus is filled with the blood. So whatever the waste products are there in the blood, they are absorbed. Now, Malpighian tubules absorb nitrogen waste products and convert them into uric acid, which is excreted out through the hindgut. So once these nitrogen wastes are absorbed from the Malpighian tubule, you must know that these nitrogen wastes are of potassium oxalate. They are potassium urate. So this uric acid, they are uric acid, potassium urate. So here, these waste products, which are absorbed by the Malpighian tubules, they come into the inside part of alimentary canal. From the alimentary canal, inside part of the alimentary canal, these excretory products, they move through the hindgut and they come out through the anus there. So, therefore, the excretory products are excreted out through the hindgut, through the anus here. So, you must know that in cockroach, the excretory product and the digestive, undigestive product, both of these are passed out through the anus. And therefore, this insect is called uricotelic because it excretes uric acid. In addition, the fat body, the nephrocytes, and uricose gland, utricular gland, also called utricular gland. Uricose glands also help in excretion. Please remember the word uricose glands. These are also helpful in the excretion process. Let us look into the nervous system. This is what a dissected open body of the cockroach. You can see there is a double ventral nerve cord. The nervous system of cockroach consists of a series of fused segmentally arranged ganglia. Look here. These are all segmentally arranged ganglia. So This is what you have, the brain. So the nervous system cockroach consists of a series of fused segmental ganglia joined by paired longitudinal connectives on the ventral side. So this is the brain of cockroach, and this is the double ventral nerve cord with segmentally placed ganglia. And these three are very prominent ganglia present in the thoracic region: prothoracic ganglion, mesothoracic ganglion, metathoracic ganglion. Then it continues in the abdominal region. So this is what you have, the brain. The brain of cockroach is also known as supraesophageal ganglion or cerebral ganglion. There are two ganglia which are fused to form one particular structure. So this is what is called supraesophageal ganglion. If at all write in another way, it is a supraesophageal ganglion or cerebral ganglion, somewhat bilobed ganglion. Okay, supraesophageal ganglion. And then you come across from here another ganglion, which is situated, this is situated above the esophagus. Supra, above the esophageal ganglion. Then you have subesophageal ganglion. This is connected by means of a connective. You have a connective. We call it a circumesophageal connective. Like this. Why it is circumesophageal? Because here you see esophagus. Then it is connected with double ventral nerve cord. Yeah, a nerve cord, two nerve cords, which are situated very close to each other. Double ventral nerve cord with the segmentally placed ganglion. And this type of nervous system is called a typical annelidan type of nervous system, which you have already heard. Annelidan type of nervous system. This is a brain or supraesophageal ganglion or cerebral ganglion. And this is a subesophageal ganglion. Sub means below. Subesophageal ganglion. Supraesophageal ganglion. And this is the connective, circumesophageal connective. So here you have, the supraesophageal ganglion. And this is the connective. And this is the subesophageal ganglion. And this is esophagus. And three, prothoracic ganglion, mesothoracic ganglion, metathoracic ganglion in the thoracic region. And this is followed by six abdominal ganglion. So three ganglia lie in the thorax and six in the abdomen. Six ganglia are situated in the abdominal region. The nervous system of cockroach is spread throughout the body. The head holds a bit of nervous system, that is the brain, while the rest is situated along the ventral part of its body. Right? So, now you understand, if the head of the cockroach is cut, and if the other part is left, you can see that the left out body part remains alive for another week time. You understand, if the head of cockroach is cut off, it is still live for as long as 1 week. Please remember, even if it lives, it cannot move. It will be living, it will be just moving its legs, but not that it can just walk and move from place to place. In a head region, the brain is represented by supraesophageal ganglion, which supplies nerves to antennae and compound eyes. Right? So this is with regard to the nervous system of a cockroach. And you know, the nervous system cockroach is known as neurogenic. Now there are two types of nervous system, myogenic and neurogenic. Neurogenic is one where the movement starts with regard to the heart situated, with regard to the pacemaker, or the one which brings about this movement from the nerves. So in this case, why? Because the neurogenic heart here, the heartbeat originates from the nerve mass. Therefore, this particular part, even though the head is separated, it still will be active. In cockroach, the sense organs are antennae, eyes, maxillary pulps, labial pulps, and anal sacs. All these are the sense organs in case of cockroach. You must remember that. We have already heard about all these parts in yesterday's class. The eye of cockroach is said to be compound. And this compound bean-shaped eyes are situated on the dorsal surface of the head. What is the peculiarity in the eye of cockroach is, the eye of cockroach, each eye is made up of about 2000 hexagonal units called ommatidia, singular ommatidium. That is, if you look into the eye of cockroach, the eye of cockroach shows number of small units. And these small units, whatever you come across in the eye of cockroach, each of these small units are, each of these is called ommatidium. Ommatidium is a singular, ommatidia plural. How many ommatidia are there? 2000. Each eye of cockroach is made up of 2000 hexagonal ommatidia. With the help of several ommatidia, a cockroach can receive several images of an object. That means, if at all you go and stand in front of the cockroach, in front of the cockroach, suppose the cockroach is there, in front of the cockroach. Now, if the light rays from your body enters into the eye of cockroach, if 40 light rays enters from your body into the eye of cockroach, 40 images are formed in the eye, 40 images of your body is formed in the eye of cockroach. The brain of cockroach, it combines all these 40 images and gives one single picture. One coherent picture is formed in the brain of a cockroach. By combining all these 40 images, one coherent image is formed. So, that is what we say that the kind of vision of cockroach is mosaic vision. Mosaic vision means that many visions get formed, not one image. That many images get formed. This kind of vision is known as mosaic vision with more sensitivity but less resolution. Very important term with reference to eye of cockroach. Eye of cockroach with more sensitivity but less resolution being common during night time. So the vision is called nocturnal vision. Cockroaches can see more perfectly at night time because their vision is adapted for dim light. But you do come across cockroaches, you know, during daytime and all. But at that time, it is difficult for them to see. And another important thing is that whenever you stand in front of the cockroach can make out that some moving object is there in front of it, and it cannot make out whether it is he standing or she standing or cat is standing or dog is standing. It can make out only some object in front of its eye. It is moving, coming nearby, going further away. That's all. So what you have to remember is that cockroach eye is adapted for dim vision, nocturnal vision, and cockroach eye, it shows what is called a mosaic vision. A number of images get formed, and all these images are concentrated or accumulated, aggregated into one coherent picture. Cockroaches are dioecious. You know, sexes are separate. Cockroaches are unisexual. You can see that, you can make out, there are two cockroaches here. One is a male, and another is a female. So, cockroaches are dioecious and both sexes have well-developed reproductive organs. In my yesterday's class, I have made it very clear how you can differentiate male cockroach from female cockroach. Male cockroach is slender. His body is narrow, elongated. In female cockroach, body is wider and it is comparatively short. And another difference, I said, the wings in male cockroach extends beyond the abdomen. And in case of female cockroach, the wings are a little bit short, exposing some part of its body. Okay, right? So now, coming to the male reproductive system, the male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes. This is what I have, a pair of testes. Lying one on each lateral side of the body, dorsolateral, one on each side of the body, dorsolateral side, in the segment 4, 5, 6. You can make out the segment where these testes are situated. It is the 4, 5, and 6. You can make out very clearly. Testes is three-lobed. Look here. This is one lobe. This is another lobe. This is the third lobe. It is a trilobed. Meripedal system consists of a pair of testes lying one on each lateral side in a segment 4, 5, and 6. Which segments? Abdomen segments. So, these are the three lobes in the abdomen segment. From each testis, arises a thin vas deferens. This is what vas deferens here, a thin duct. A narrow duct arises from each testis. What is it called? It is called vas deferens. Vas deferens. And this vas deferens opens into a seminal vesicle. Each vas deferens opens into seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle in turn opens into ejaculatory duct. In this diagram, you cannot see the seminal vesicle because it is on the other side. What you are seeing is from above, from dorsal side of cockroach, which is the dorsal side of cockroach, where you see the wings of cockroach. That is the dorsal side. Which is the ventral side? Where the cockroach has the legs, it is ventral side. So, from each testis arises a duct, and this duct is called vas deferens. Vas deferens opens into ejaculatory duct. It opens into ejaculatory duct via or through seminal vesicle. So, vas deferens opens into seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle opens into ejaculatory duct. You can't see the seminal vesicle because this structure, it covers it when you see from above, when you see from dorsal side. The ejaculatory duct opens into male gonopore. You can make out here clearly, this is ejaculatory duct. Ejaculatory duct. These are the trilobed testes. Arising from the testes, vas deferens. Vas deferens leads to seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle leads to the ejaculatory duct. And this ejaculatory duct opens out by means of male genital aperture. Male gonopore. You cannot see the male gonopore because the gonopopysis is covering it. You know, gonopopysis is nothing but male genitalia, male external genitalia. So it is covering it. So here, somewhere just beneath that, the ejaculatory duct opens by male genital aperture or male gonopore. And this male gonopore is situated ventral to anus. This is the anus. Ventral to anus, where here you come across the genital pore. In the male reproductive system, there is a characteristic mushroom-shaped gland. Look here. This is what a mushroom-like gland. Mushroom-shaped gland is present in which segment? Always it is asked. This is present in 6th and 7th abdominal segments. Mushroom-shaped gland is present in 6th and 7th segment. You have heard about 4, 5, 6. This is a 7. Already you have seen the testis is present in segment 4, 5, 6, and this is a 7th segment. You can see that the mushroom-shaped gland is present in 6th and 7th segment, abdomen segment, which functions as an accessory reproductive gland. Mushroom-shaped gland is present as an accessory reproductive gland. Accessory reproductive gland means the gland, additional gland associated with the reproductive system. Of course, it has some role to play with reference to the cover of this spermatophore. There is what is called a spermatophore in case of the cockroaches, which is nothing but a sperm bundle. He said it's a spermatophore packet. The sperms will be there. And that wall of the spermatophore is formed by that of this additional reptile gland, accessory gland called the mushroom shaped gland. And apart from that, you also see in this, there is one more gland called phallic gland. There is one more gland, club-shaped gland. This club-shaped gland is referred to as a phallic gland. Phallic gland, it also helps in the reproductive process of the male cockroach. Phallic gland, whatever you see there, it is also called by another term, what is called conglobate gland. Conglobate gland. Phallic gland is also referred to as conglobate gland. Right? Conglobate gland. Phallic gland. Now, the external genitalia are represented by male gonopoiesis. Male gonopoiesis, otherwise known as phallomere. Phallomere, male gonopoiesis are one and the same. Therefore, external genitalia, gonopoiesis, and phallomere are one and the same. The external genitalia are represented by male gonopoiesis or phallomere. You can see here, right phallomere, ventral phallomere, left phallomere. Phallomere refers to external genitalia. So they include left phallomere, right phallomere, ventral phallomere, and you must also know that the left phallomere, associated with the left phallomere, we have two processes. One is called pseudopenis, and it's called titillator. Both are helpful in copulation process of cockroach. Right? So, the external genitalia represented by male gonopoiesis or phallomere, they are nothing but chitinous asymmetrical structure surrounding the male gonopore. These are chitinous structures, asymmetrical structures. They are not symmetrical. Asymmetrical structures present around the male gonopore. The sperms are stored in a seminal vesicle, which is present just beneath that. Beneath that, there is seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle and are glued. That means they are made to attach to one another. They are glued together in the form of bundles called spermatophore. What is spermatophore? Spermatophore is a bundle of sperms. Just like you have what you call BD. You have that bundle of BD, which is a smoker. Like that, you have bundle of sperms referred to as spermatophore, which are discharged during copulation. This is a diagram of a male reproductive system. You must know very well all the labelings of this reproductive system. Let us look into female reproductive system. The female reproductive system consists of two large ovaries. Look at whatever you see in yellow color. These are the two large ovaries. If at all you cut open the cockroach, yesterday I have told you, best way of studying cockroach is to kill the cockroach by putting it in soap water with the foam, and after killing that, spraying on that some perfume, whatever you are using for body perfume, and then handling that and studying each and every part. Another way is, I used to generally teach this subject by holding a cockroach, taking a cockroach in hand, cutting open it, and showing all these digestive system, reproductive system in a classroom by dissecting it in front of the students and showing it. That is very wonderful. So you can also cut open the body and see that. You will see this beautifully yellow-colored ovary in the body. The female reproductive system consists of two large ovaries. Look here. These are the two large ovaries lying laterally in second to sixth abdominal segment. You must know that it starts from second to sixth. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Second to sixth abdominal segment. In which segments are testes are present? Testes are present in the segments 4, 5, 6. And ovaries are present in the segment 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So definitely the ovaries are much bigger than that of the testes. Each ovary is formed of a group of 8 ovarian tubules or ovaries. Look here. This, what you see? What you see? These are ovarian tubules. How many are there? If at all you start counting, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is there on the other side. Other three ovarian tubules are there on the other side. So, each ovary is formed of 8 ovarian tubules. 8 ovarian tubules. Other is called ovarioles. Other is called ovarioles. Containing a chain of developing ova. So, you have inside these ovaries, you have ova. You have ova. You do come across ova. Okay. Always you see the immature ova on the top. Immature. Mature ovum in the bottom. So, each ovary is formed of a group of 8 ovarian tubules. These are all 8 ovarian tubules. These tubules are called ovaries, containing a chain of developing ova. So, in each, every ovariole, there will be ova. There will be ova. Growing ova. The fully grown at the bottom. And less grown or immature on the top. Like that. Okay? So, oviducts of each ovary. Oviduct. These are all ovaries. Ovaries. Ovaries contain chain of developing ova. The ovaries. Ovaries are the tubules inside the ovary. So, oviducts of each ovary, oviduct, this is the oviduct of this ovary, this is the oviduct of this ovary. Oviducts of each ovary unite into a single median oviduct. That means, ovaries lead to oviduct, oviducts lead, oviducts of this side and oviducts of this side, both these lead to what is called common oviduct or vagina. Oviducts of each ovary unite into a single median oviduct, also called vagina, which opens into genital chamber. This opens into genital chamber. This is the genital chamber. Opens into genital chamber. A pair of spermatheca, you can see here. This is what is spermatheca. One is a sac-like, another is a filamentous. A pair of spermatheca is present in the sixth segment. Very important. It is present in the sixth segment, which opens into genital chamber. That also opens into genital chamber. Sperms are transferred through spermatophore. You must remember that spermatheca is always a part of female reproductive system. Spermatheca is always concerned with the storing of the sperms received during copulation. So I have already told you that in case of male, the sperms are bundled together to form a packet. And this packet is called spermatophore. So, when this spermatophore is deposited here, the spermatophore, which contains the sperms, all these sperms are stored inside the spermatheca. Right? Inside spermatheca. So, the fertilized eggs are encased in capsule called ootheca. So, this is what egg case or ootheca. They contain fertilized eggs. Fertilized eggs are encased in capsules called ootheca. O refers to ova. Theca refers to cover. So, ootheca refers to small capsules containing fertilized eggs. Right? When these spermatophores are deposited, from these spermatophores, sperms come out, and these sperms fertilize the eggs, and these fertilized eggs, they get encased, and such encased fertilized eggs are called ootheca. You can see this ootheca. You might have seen many times cockroach carrying this tiny structure in its rear end of the body. Rear end of the body, and this is ootheca. Ootheca is a dark reddish to blackish brown in color. Dark reddish or blackish brown in color. About 3 upon 8 inch or 8 millimeter long. 3 upon 8 inch or 8 millimeter long, each of these. Reddish brown colored ootheca. These ootheca are dropped or glued. They are made to attach to some object. They are dropped or glued to a suitable surface, usually in a crack or a crevice of high relative humidity near a food source. Most of the time, they will be very much near to the wash basin in the kitchen or near to that. They are dropped or glued to a suitable surface, just like that. Suitable surface, usually in a crack or crevice of high relative humidity near a food source. You cannot remove them. They just get attached firmly there. Okay. These are OTK of different species of cockroaches. And remember, inside each OTK, on an average, female produces 9 to 10 OTK. 9 to 10. This is one OTK. 9 to 10 OTK a one female produces during its lifetime, each containing 14 to 16 eggs. That means, if at all you have one cockroach, it can produce 9 to 10 utika. In each utika, there will be 14 to 16. Let us remember, if at all you have one pair of cockroach, one male and female, how much it will produce? It will produce 160 young ones. 160. 10 into 16. 160 young ones. These are all the young one of cockroach, white one. And you know these young one of cockroaches are always called by the term nymph. N-Y-M-P-H. N-Y-M-P-H. Nymph is the term that we use for the young ones of cockroach. On an average, female produce 9 to 10 utika, each utike, each containing 14 to 16 eggs. Look here. These are all tiny, cute young ones. White. Young ones of cockroaches will be white. Okay. The development of Periplanet americana, Periplanet americana is a scientific name of cockroach, is a pauro-metabolus. What is that pauro-metabolus? Pauro-metabolus refers to gradual metamorphosis. Pauro-metabolus, gradual. Gradual metamorphosis. And also, you say that it is a hemi-metabolic, gradual metamorphosis. We also say that cockroach shows hemi-metabolic. What is it, hemi-metabolic? Hemi-metabolic is the one, is a phenomenon where the young one gets transformed into the adult with a little change. Whenever the young one gets transformed into adult, with a little change, then the metamorphosis is referred to as hemimetaboly. When the young one changes to adult, gradually it is called pauro-metaboly. Therefore, cockroach shows both hemimetaboly and pauro-metaboly. So, the development of cockroach is referred to as both hemimetabolus and pauro-metabolus. Hemimetabolus refers to, with a little change, the young one gets transformed into adult. Pauro-metabolus remains, it is the change is a gradual, not a sudden change. This is in contrast with the butterfly. You might have seen this caterpillar larva of butterfly. The caterpillar larva of butterfly changes into adult with tremendous changes, with a lot of changes. Therefore, the development of a butterfly is always known as holometaboly. Holometaboly is the one where the larva changes into adult with a lot of changes. Holometaboly, this is a pauro-metaboly. In case of silverfish, you might have heard about Lepisma. There is what is called silverfish, which is always seen in your bookshelves. Bookshelves, a tiny creature seen in a bookshelf. Bookshelves, along with the book, it is called silverfish. It is not fish, it is an arthropod. Silverfish never shows any metamorphosis. It is called ametaboly. It shows what is called ametabolus. A means absent. Absence of metamorphosis. So, the development of Periplanet americana is pauro-metabolus, meaning there is a development through nymphal stages. These are all the nymphs. The nymphs look very much like adult. Only difference between the nymph and adult, look here, these are all the nymphs. Only thing is that in the size, in the color. But in the color, these are all so beautiful, white, cute, young one, nymph. And these gradually increase in size. And only with the development of wings on the outside and gonads on the inner side, with the two changes, what is that? On the outer side, they develop wings. What happens on the inner side? The inner side, the gonads become mature. With the gonads becoming mature on the inner side and wings developing outer side, the nymph gets transformed into adult. The nymph grows by molting about 13 times. You know, all insects are known to show molting. Molting is nothing but ecdysis, wherein the outer exoskeleton, non-living outer exoskeleton, is replaced by another exoskeleton, newly formed exoskeleton. The nymph grows by molting about 13 times to reach the adult form. Remember, you must know how many UTK are produced by one cockroach during its lifetime, and how many eggs are there inside each cockroach, and how many times of molting the cockroach shows during its lifetime, or nymph grows. The nymph grows into adult by molting about 13 times. The next to last nymph stage, whenever this nymph molts 1 to 2 to 3 to 4, before the last, the next to last nymph stage, wings, wing pad develops, but only adult cockroaches have wings. The moment any cockroach shows wings, it is adult. If there is no wing, see here, these are adults. No wing, it is a young. It is considered as immature. The moment the wings are developed on the outer side, it is to be considered as the cockroach has matured enough and it is capable of reproduction. Many species of cockroaches are wild and are of no economic importance. Only they are of some importance to people like Chinese. They eat everything. They eat everything whatever other people may not eat in the whole world. So they eat even cockroaches. They fry cockroach. They eat cockroach. That is what I have showed you at the beginning of the lecture, in my last lecture. Many species of cockroaches are wild and are of no economic importance. A few species thrive in and around human habitat. You do come across cockroaches inside our houses. And remember, these are unwanted guests called pest. And the moment you spot them, you have to kill them and throw them out, or you always keep a cockroach repellent in the form of some of this semi-solid paste. They are pests because they destroy our food and contaminate with their smelly excreta. Very bad. So they are known to transmit the diseases. They are very dangerous. They can transmit a variety of bacterial diseases by contaminating our food material. Okay, so that's all what you have to know about these cockroaches. Are you scared of cockroaches? No, not at all. You know, these cockroaches are capable of eating our skin. Many times, whenever these skins get dead and get broken, especially at the elbow joint and knee joint, etc., in the elderly people, these cockroaches at night time, they come and eat those tissues also, dead tissues also. And don't encourage these cockroaches. Keep away always cockroaches away from your houses. And you always see cockroach repellent are used. And one cockroach is sufficient to bring about so many contagious diseases. Okay, that's all about today's lecture. With this, we have completed the study on cockroach, and we'll be meeting with another new chapter in my next class. Till then, bye-bye to you. Bye, see you.
Welcome to Sushruta app. In this video, we are going to demo NEET topics and its related resources from slides and videos. Kindly give all the necessary permission and proceed to the main screen. Let us select Biology 11th as our subject. This will open up the syllabus for this subject. All the syllabus data regarding the subject will be loaded at this stage. Once the process is complete, the icon will be active. Zoom a bit so that the topics are clearly visible and click on the orange highlighter button. This will open up a selection box. Adjust the box so that it covers the topic you are interested in. Once this is done, confirm your selection by clicking on the green button. This will download the slides resources for that unit. Once the download is complete, it will ask you for the permission to download the textbooks from the NCERT site. Once the download is complete, it will open up the chapter and the subchapter hierarchy for the unit. Select one of the subchapter. In this case, I am selecting the first subchapter. It will load all the resources pertaining to that topic. Let us click the second icon, that is textbook. You will be given an option if there are many resources. Now you can see, it has directly taken us to the page of the selected topic. Click on the small green button to load all the icons back. Similarly, let us select the third icon, that is slides. It will open up the slides for the said topic. Finally, let us select the third icon, that is YouTube videos. This will show the videos related to the topic from IITPAL. If there are more than one video, select any one of the links and watch the video. Similarly, let us select another topic and follow the same procedure. Remember, downloading of slides is a one-time process per unit. Slides are being downloaded here, as we have visited this unit for the first time. The next time we visit the same unit, slides will be retrieved locally. We can also select a topic from slides and get its equivalent matching resource. In this case, I am selecting the topic, taxonomic categories, and getting its equivalent topic from the textbook. So here we have the textbook resource showing taxonomic categories. When there are too many topics selected, or the topic name match is not found, the list of entire topics will be shown to the student. He can select any one topic and proceed further. Let's click on the Moodle icon, seen on the syllabus screen. This will take you to the Moodle calendar, where you will be able to view all the scheduled events. Let us click on one of the events. There is an event for Biology Unit 1. On clicking it, we'll give a live lecture Google Meet link in it. Clicking on the link will directly open up Google Meet app where the lecture will be taken. Let us select a topic from the biology syllabus and proceed further. Now let us click the first icon that is GyanChat. GyanChat is a medium where the students can interact with the other students via channels. Each subject unit will be having its own dedicated channel. Students can share their doubts or thoughts via this channel. GyanChat Moodle would directly take you to the course material for that particular unit. These course materials will be uploaded on Moodle by the lectures. Now let us try out a different subject, that is physics. Let us click the textbook icon and select the second option. This will open up a message box displaying the page number of the Kindle version of HC Verma book. On clicking OK, it will open up the Kindle app with the book loaded. Once the book is loaded, click on the hamburger icon on the top and select the Go To option. This opens up a dialog box asking you to enter the page number. Enter the same page number, which was shown to you earlier, and click OK. This will directly take you to the page related to the topic you selected. Now let us see the formula sheet for physics. Formula sheet is provided to get a quick reference of all the formulas covered in the syllabus. If you want to refer to a topic from the formula sheet, simply select the topic and proceed further. We are also providing a link to the CEngage app. On clicking the CEngage icon, it will open the CEngage app. You will find all the test material inside My Bookshelf option. Finally, you can take the mock tests using the National Test Appeals app. Clicking on the icon will take you directly to the National Test Appeals app, where you can try out mock tests. Whenever a QR code is found inside the textbook, the student can select the QR code and he will be provided with e-content material. In this particular case, we have contents related to text PDF. In some cases, there will be video content, graphic and interactive content. Let us see how video content would look like from a different chapter.
Hello, my dear students. Very glad to meet you all. I am Professor G.K. Bhatt. In 2018 or during 2018 to 2020, I got an opportunity to visit nearly 25 institutions, and I used to teach in all these institutions biology, preparing the students for NEET exam. For NEET exam, you must be thorough with each and every word given in NCERT book, that means biology,
you have to buy out the initiative. Not simply by hatting, understanding the concept and by hatting. That is what is expected. Now let us start with this particular chapter, that is Animal Kingdom. And we shall look into the various components that is given here in the Animal Kingdom chapter. Under basis of classification. What we are looking, what characters, what points we are looking to classify the animals. That is what we are studying under basis of classification. In spite of differences in structure and form of different animals, there are a lot of differences in the structure, in their form, gross morphology. There are certain fundamental features common to various individuals. There are certain features common to various individuals in relation to arrangement of cells, body symmetry, nature of coelom, patterns of digestive system, circulatory system, or respiratory.
We also have live lectures by world-class and dedicated tutors.
Well, that's all for this demo. Thanks for watching.